London.
The fireworks welcomed in the new year and marked the losses of the old.
I declare before you all that my whole life, whether it be long or short, shall be devoted to your service.
In Edinburgh, the first Hogmanay event.
The BBC is interrupting its normal programmes to bring you an important announcement.
This is not a drill. We interrupt our regular programming to broadcast this emergency alert. BBC, as well as all other TV stations in the United Kingdom and the Commonwealth realms, shall now broadcast His Majesty the King's address to the United Kingdom and the Commonwealth realms. Please stand by. Good evening, my loyal subjects. To make sure everyone receives this message, I shall not speak to you in person, but through an emergency alert, as this is important. Throughout her life, my beloved mother, Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, was a major role model to me and the entire country. She was the best queen ever. However, her decolonization and her inactivity as the British Empire fell made her a weak queen. She oversaw the United Kingdom going from the most powerful country in the world to a literal joke. The United Kingdom's former glory must be restored. First of all, UK Parliament shall be dissolved, effective immediately. Democracy has failed us for too long. The House of Lords' superiority over the House of Commons shall be restored and the House of Lords' reform shall be overturned. UK Conservatives shall be banned and that Tory idiot Rishi shall be fired from office as Prime Minister in favour of Sir Keir Starmer, the leader of the opposition. David Cameron, Theresa May, Boris Johnson, Liz Truss and Rishi Sunak shall be arrested and charged with corruption. MPs, go home. By 6 o'clock GMT 2nd of January 2023, all citizens of the UK and the realms must pledge allegiance to me and the Crown. Any who do not will lose their citizenship. And from that point onwards, pledging allegiance to the Crown shall be an official requirement for citizenship within the UK and the realms, for it is my God-given right to rule. Any treason against the Crown is now illegal. After pledging allegiance, conscription will begin. All able-bodied men from ages 16 to 50 shall be conscripted into the Royal Armed Forces. This will be necessary as our military presence is increasing. Security must be improved, especially in Scotland, Wales, Northern Ireland, and Cornwall, where the independence movements are currently being quelled in order to prevent rebellion and independence. Scottish Parliament, Welsh Senate and Northern Irish Assembly shall be permanently dissolved, and any Scottish, Welsh or Northern Irish nationalist parties shall be banned. Scottish First Minister Nicola Sturgeon shall be fired, arrested and charged with corruption in favour of Anas Sawar, leader of Scottish Labour. It's time. The United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland shall be reorganised into the British Empire and I shall now give myself the title of British Emperor, effective immediately. We are now an absolute monarchy once more. The Commonwealth realms shall all be incorporated into the British Empire and military presence shall be increased there. Any former realms, most notably including Ireland and India, shall be forced to join the Empire or else they shall feel my wrath and will be besieged by the armed forces by tomorrow afternoon. My claim to the French throne shall also be restored and the illegitimate French Fifth Republic shall be overthrown. The USA will also be reclaimed like the breakaway colony it is. Any parliaments within the realms shall be dissolved. Protesting shall be temporarily legalized in order to promote stability. Anti-government activist groups such as republic.org.uk shall be banned. civil unrest will not be tolerated. A temporary curfew from 20 o'clock to 7 o'clock shall be in place. Anyone out past curfew instantly brands themselves as kill on sight. My and my wife Camilla's coronation shall be moved from the 6th of May to the 2nd of June, the 70-year anniversary of my mother Elizabeth II's. The coronation shall be royally lavish and plans to make it simpler and shorter have been overturned. The Koh-i-Noor diamond will defiantly be present at the coronation and will not be returned to India, as it is the main gemstone in the crown of Queen Elizabeth, which will be worn by Her Majesty the Queen at the coronation. The Stone of Scone and the Cullinan diamond will also not be returned to Scotland and South Africa respectively. Any propositions to slim down the monarchy have been cancelled. Also, my children and grandchildren shall be removed from the line of succession due to influence from my ex-wife, Princess Diana. Prince Andrew shall also be removed due to his criminal record. Prince Harry, Princess Meghan, Prince Archie and Princess Lilibet shall be permanently exiled from the royal family due to their treason. However, Prince Harry, Prince Archie and Princess Lilibet will be eligible to return should Harry divorce Meghan. The book Spare has been banned. Princess Beatrice shall be instantly created Princess of Wales and have her investiture on the 1st of July and shall be crowned with the coronet of George, Prince of Wales. The Mopelli Motsi Kautsi shall be recognised. And lastly, my brother Prince Edward will be created Duke of Edinburgh per the wishes of our late father, His Royal Highness Prince Philip. Here's a recap of everything I just said in case you weren't paying attention. Parliament dissolved and Conservatives banned. All citizens must pledge allegiance to the Crown. Conscription begins and security tightens. UK reorganised into British Empire. Protest ban and curfew. Coronation day moved. Monarchy slimmed down cancelled and Princess Beatrice named successor. Thank you all for listening to this emergency alert. The national and royal anthem of the British Empire, God Save the King, shall now play. Good night and God save the King.
out across the city, despite rain and freezing temperatures.